So I welcome you all to this amazing session of PD Roundtable. In this session, I'll be speaking with Ankit Jindal about the effective strategies to optimize the digital presence of law firms. So let's start with about your views about what is actually which is creating the need for this digital environment, not even for law firms, but yes, for every company in the present scenario of pandemic.
See, obviously the pandemic has created a huge opportunity for law firms to mark their presence in the digital world. Law firms are actually not only just law firms, but lawyers as such in general are realizing the fact of having one's presence in the digital arena, as well as having not only their practice area or their firm's expertise getting visualized, but rather having one's own opinion or one's achievements being recognized and being appreciated online. And the pandemic has given a more opportunistic window to law firms to understand where they used to be hesitant about earlier, about adapting to these digital methods of having oneself present in the online space. It has given them the opportunity to understand, to adapt and execute, as well as implement strategies which might be effective for their marketing goals, right? And they have started creating BD roles, started engaging with the PR agencies, started engaging with the marketing teams, started engaging, looking at digital strategies. So this has created a new horizon for them to look into. I think a new vertical has been opened through this pandemic, and it's a great start because this is something that India needs for its service industry to get outside in the online space. Many of the foreign firms are doing it, and it was high time that India has started recognizing this initiative and efforts as well.
Yes, that's really interesting. I mean, pandemic has made all of us realize the importance of digital marketing. Although we were all in the BD teams, we all were aware about the importance of digital marketing, but yes, we were not very serious about it. Law firms used to have social media channels and other, but even their spending on the digital marketing was very low.
Right. Even today, if you talk about the budgets for the marketing initiatives or for the marketing department, they are still restricted to some end, because it is difficult for, I won't say difficult, but I would say there is still some hesitance about keeping a big budget for the marketing vertical or the marketing department in a law firm currently. But big law firms, if you talk about top tier law firms, if you talk about Big Fours, they have realized the importance of marketing themselves. And marketing just does not mean, like, obviously we are restricted as a law firm or as a lawyer not to advertise and solicit. So many of the law firms have understood the concept of, or the ways to actually portray certain information in a manner which does not amount to advertisement or solicitation. So keeping that in mind, either it is through audio marketing, through video marketing, or through content marketing, they have started optimizing the strategies, which we will talk about through certain questions that you will put forward. But they have started optimizing their marketing strategies and have adapted themselves to the changing needs, right? Because not only a lawyer is online, your potential clients are online these days. They are on Insta, they are on LinkedIn, they are on other social media channels, they are Google searching for a law firm. So how do you get yourself recognized or get yourself even searchable through different mediums is something that law firms are heavily counting upon, and they are starting to realize this fact now.
Yes, Ankit, that is really need of the hour. So this lands me to our first question, that what is that basic criteria or the basic point of strategy for a lawyer or a law firm to start optimizing their digital presence? What is that basic, basic step of ladder they would need to follow in the optimizing their online presence?
So, first of all, for every law firm or any lawyer who wants to start building a strategy for marketing or anything, first needs to understand where they currently stand as of now. Like, do a digital audit for themselves first, where their name appears. If they are typing for particular keywords on a search engine, so understand yourself and the consumer behavior. Whatever you are typing is the similar fashion the consumer will also be typing. So if you do a digital audit and you see where your current standing is as of now, then you are in a good position to understand the gaps, the challenges, and the strategies that can be implemented. So first and foremost, do a digital audit, and it should be consistent throughout the year, whether do it biannually or annually. But one should do a digital audit to see and understand where the person is or the firm is standing as of now. Secondly, one should understand that if you want to market, you need to build a brand. So have a consistent branding throughout your collaterals, throughout your website, social media. Understand what kind of content has to go in which style, which format. Third, understand your competitors as well. Many of the law firms do not do competitor analysis, just build on the strategies and do the marketing. Understand your competitors, your entrepreneurs, your big fours, your LPOs and boutique law firms. These are all your competitors, because the demand from your clients have changed. They are looking for more specific expertise or specific services from a law firm sometimes. So does your law firm provide that? If India being one of the growing startup economy, does your law firm provide startup advisory or not? Do you have a department of that or not? So understand, or do you need to collaborate with another firm which will help you with the startup advisory or not? So these are something that one has to build upon. So digital audit, brand building, and competitor analysis will be the three main things I will say that one should focus upon when starting a bit marketing strategy.
So what would be your views to optimizing a website? Suppose a law firm has a website, but they don't know how to optimize it. The keyword research or the SEO or the implementing some other social media links, or how we can really go about it. Like, website is a very basic thing wherein our prospects or our competitors really log in and check about our presence.
Right. So I would say website being the basic, it is one of the most fundamental things for a law firm as well. And it should be responsive on all the platforms. If you want to optimize it, it should be every platform, even a MacBook or a Windows PC will have a different outlook for that website. So one has to optimize it on both the screens, on tablets, on the mobiles. It should be easily accessible and visually appealing on all the platforms, all the devices. Secondly, for optimizing the website, the content should be SEO optimized itself. So understand the keywords, mark your keywords, figure out the keywords that you want to use when one is searching on the search engine. So content can be created to have more searchability rates at the search engine portals. And then have... For do not have any missed links. All the links should be connected. Many a times I've found it on the website that if you click on a link, it is going to a page where it is written forbidden 403 gateway or something like that, or it is not clickable, or the link is broken. So have any link that is being posted on the website, it would create good credibility for the website in terms of website ranking, in terms of searchability, in terms of optimizing on, if you type for a particular ABC law firm on the Google search engine. So there are categories on the Google page also, like practice areas, contact us section, and everything that Google shows. So these are through optimizing of those links. So sit with the developer, devote some time, have a marketing personnel do it. And it takes time. You want to restructure it. So every concept requires a devotion of time and understanding of every platform. And for the website, similarly, one has to take care of the minute details, because minute details which affects the more. The larger picture can be still be scrolled down or anything like that.
So one primary source of promotion nowadays is social media. Each and every individual is nowadays utilizing it, be it for business, personal, or be it any other way. So what are your views on this, Ankit? How social media really help the lawyers, law firms? Although we know that there are restrictions by the BCI on the Indian law firms and lawyers, how we can really optimize those channels wherein we cannot directly solicit, but yes, how we can really pursue to optimize those for our betterment?
So this is an interesting one, as many of the law firms are utilizing social media handles, and law firms being a professional service industry, for them LinkedIn is the most sorted out social media channel, right? So one needs to understand, I have seen like law firms have channels on YouTube, have handles on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, along with LinkedIn. But the content posted on all of these platforms is same. So one has to understand that every platform was created for a particular use or a particular content, and one needs to give out that content respecting that particular platform. So if you want to go for Instagram, understand the platform completely first. Have different creatives made for Instagram, have different content for LinkedIn. LinkedIn itself provides good options for article posting, for video. Understand that LinkedIn also, for optimizing LinkedIn, the videos have to be optimized particularly for LinkedIn, just not post the link as such, so that it shows uniformly on your page. Have showcase pages for your practice areas, for pro bono or CSR activities. For Twitter, Twitter is more opinionated or more conversational type of a platform. So have good social listening in terms of, so when we use the term social listening, we refer to listening in terms of what other industry peers are doing, right? And appreciate that, even flow out certain comments on that, or share some knowledge over that particular topic through your chat, through your medium. Then for Facebook, one can optimize it as per the Facebook platform, and it is more personal. Facebook, I believe it's more personal. It can be more personal, professional, both terms. So highlighting your people's achievements, highlighting HR activities that have been done in the firm, that can be on Facebook, because I believe LinkedIn does not require your HR activities that are happening or any social gathering that is happening on your in your firm to be posted on LinkedIn, because many a times I have seen that LinkedIn within the LinkedIn community, I've seen people commenting that do not make this a Facebook platform, and people are that serious about how one communicates on LinkedIn because it's a professional network. So people are more interested in professional content, which is relatable, not very legal savvy, which many of the people don't understand. Only lawyers or the people related to law will understand. So that is one target audience, but your target audience is not just defined by those people. Your target audience are your law students, your potential clients, your people who might be interested in a certain type of law or certain type of subject or a case. So accordingly, one can create content on LinkedIn, and content can be diversified. It can be diversified through various instruments like articles, videos, and audios. So understand where your audience lies, what will you be able to contribute. And if you have time, then only go for all types of strategies. First, take it step by step, and then market yourself accordingly.
That's really well said, Ankit. I think we all have to understand the primary step is to understand about the target audience, about their presence. And secondary step would be to understand about the purpose of the platform before we decide on going for that platform. And second would be the value we want to drive out of it.
Right.
I think these two are the basic effective strategy, I would say, to utilize any social media platform: the purpose and the value.
Correct.
Once we have sorted out these two, I would say these two major steps, I think we can optimize anything, not even just a law firm website, but I think we can optimize any particular strategy out of these two basic steps.
That is rightly said, Rahul. Having the value and the purpose out of anything that we do. Even in personal life, we think of what is the value and purpose of what we are doing. So why not in the professional life, we have to be more, determined and more cautious about that.
So Ankit, would you like to conclude this session, and we'll start with the roundtable session with the audience?